episode 2080, Through the Eyes of Faith.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy Happy Day. How are you doing? I really want to know how your heart is feeling. Today is Sweet Spirit Sunday. It's a time of reflection, your vertical relationship with God. I know life gets crazy and we get it so jam-packed. But what if you saw today through the eyes of faith? For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, what if you saw today through the eyes of faith? Declare the good because all the bad already stands out. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. You know, too much of our days are filled with worldly junk. I mean, come on, let's just say it like it is. It's hard to escape it because we hear its murmurs in our Instagram feed. When we go and look on Facebook and we're shopping for something a little less expensive, so we go to those groups and we're like, oh yeah, and then all this other junk pops up. We hear it on news clips. We even hear it on traditional television. How much of life are you experiencing through a worldly lens or through the eyes of faith? Now, some would say, okay, what is faith? It's a good question. Well, Hebrews 11:1 addresses it. Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So there's this assurance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. What are you hoping for? What are you dreaming of? Where do you want to take your family? Where do you want to take your relationship with God? Now, I know my weeks get long, as I'm sure yours do too. It's easy to fall into the habit of just going through the motions. And I'm one to be real honest here because there are days that the Bible doesn't get opened. And I rely on only the communication of maybe a quick devotion or an email subscription that I have that draws me in for a brief moment and then I'm done and I move on. And I know we all can relate to that. But really, God wants us to live our everyday with Him, through His eyes, not our eyes. And it's so difficult. Well, this past week, I took some time to walk outside every single day. I did not miss a day. And when I say a lot of outside time, it was at least an hour. Now, there's nothing better for the soul than immersing yourself in nature. And during this time, I began to ask, what if? What if I saw God in all the little things? What if I believed what I've learned about God's promise? Truly believed what I've learned? What if I obeyed His calling on my life? What if I walked with confidence knowing God has gone before me? What if I was the hands and feet of Jesus, not just to strangers, but to my family? What if I dreamed of God-sized dreams? What if? What if you saw God in your everyday? Instead of going, oh, yeah, well, it's another day. It's a Monday on a Tuesday. It's a Monday on a Wednesday. It's a Monday on a Thursday. And we all have those moments. I get it. And that's okay. But when you live that out every single day, not just for moments, but for weeks upon months upon years, what do you think you're doing with your life? How do you think your spirit is feeling? Heavy. This is the day that the Lord has made. You can do with it what you want, but what if? What if you saw through the eyes of faith? Faith, the assurance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. If you flip to the previous chapter, Hebrews 10, verses 35 and 36, it reads this: "So do not throw away this confident trust in the Lord. Remember the great reward it brings you. Patient endurance is what you need now, so that you will continue to do God's will. Then you will receive all that He has promised." Oh my goodness, if that doesn't refresh the soul, I don't know what will. Do not throw away this confident trust in the Lord. But let's be real, we do it, don't we? We do the complete opposite. We whine, yell, and scream why things are not working the way we see them, the way we want them. We have to have patient endurance. That means, yes, we may have to keep working for a long time. You may have to keep working on that business that you think should have happened 6 months ago, but you're now into a year and a half, 2 years, 3 years, and you're like, I'm not where I want to be. Patient endurance is what you need now. It's not about your eyes, but God's eyes. Declare the good and clean your lenses. Do not throw away your confidence, for it will be richly rewarded. Through the eyes of faith, not worldly junk, not the things that people are saying, oh, but you got to do it this way. And if you don't, you're going to miss out. No, it's through the eyes of faith. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what He has promised. What if you saw today through the eyes of faith? What would it look like? What would it change for you? How would it change your heart? How would it change your smile? How would it change your interactions with your family? How would it change your rest? How would it change your worship? What if? What if? This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. May you go out knowing that God is richly blessing you. You may not be able to see it, but remember, it's all through the eyes of faith. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.